Hello, welcome back to Let's Play a Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now entering West Guia. Yep. Interesting music. Miles says, here we are. This is Guia, the town of ironworks. Avon says, it's a very strange town. You can tell just by the music. What's that over there? Over there? How can they see through all this? I don't know. It looks like a narrow bridge. But there are no rails to grab on. A boy's voice says, it's a truck for carrying iron. What? Says Avon. I said it's a truck for carrying iron. The boy says, steel produced at the factory is placed on trucks and carried along those rails to the town. From here it will be delivered to various places in Elfilden. Wow. You know a lot. Yeah, just ask me anything. Is it your first visit to Guia? Are you just passing through, or did you come here to find a job? Actually, we're looking for someone. Looking for someone? Is that person living in Guia? If so, I think I can help you. We don't know if she lives here, but there is a good chance she headed this way. Well, if that's all you have, it will be difficult to find her. Instead of trying to find her yourselves, why don't you ask the Adventurer Guild to find her for you? They're cheap, quick, and reliable. Well, the Adventurer Guild. You're talking to them. At least two of them. We don't need to ask the Guild for help. We belong to the Adventurer Guild ourselves. Miles says, it's like we hired ourselves. Really? I didn't know you could become adventurers at such a young age. Avon says, even though we are young, we are more than capable of being adventurers. So you are adventurers from the guild. Well, this is perfect. Mile asks, what's perfect? I have a proposition for you. Oops. I'll talk to you later. Oh. What the hell? Someone's coming. A gentle woman says, he always gives me trouble. Where has he gone? She's pretty. He hasn't mastered his spells completely. Excuse me. Have you seen a boy with golden hair? He is about 13 years old. We just passed him. He headed north. I knew he was here playing. Thank you very much. I must go now. I'm in a hurry. I won't let him get away today. Bye. Who were they? Says Avon. I don't know. A boy and his much older sister, maybe. The boy was about the same age as Ruka we met in Borin. Speaking of Ruka, Avon says, he said he was working at a factory in this town. Since we're here, why don't we visit him? That's a good idea. He said he would try and gather information about Imel. I wonder if Ruka found his sister. Maybe that's his sister. I thought his sister is younger, though. Like, younger than him. I could be remembering wrong. East is New Borin and Garden Hill. Yeah, I assume we're going to be going to Garden Hill at some point. Now, this is nothing. This is... Oh, you're completely blocking me from going, but thank you for the rare potion. I'm guessing there's no door here. Okay. It's locked. Wow. How rude. Hello? Josie says, Guia is a big town, but I'm the only kid around here. And there was another kid we just talked to. Ruka is too busy to play with me. I'm bored. How about that one boy that we just talked to? That's not Ruka. Anne says, poisonous gas erupted in New Borin. Yeah, I know, he came from there. I have many friends who live there. I'm worried. Don't worry, says Avon. The problem was resolved. So people of New Borin are safe? I'm relieved hearing it. I like the song. Alright, so we can't go in here. Cecil says, her name's Cecil? My husband works in the mine. Usually the miners eat the lunch supplied in the mine, but my husband returns home for me. I'm happy. Glad you're happy. Boss Graham says, I love to have delicious lunch, but every time I go back to town, the miners make fun of me. Well, that's because you're a big sissy boy. Fine. A stimulant, good. To replace the one we used, now we're back up to our maximum of 10. Faye says, I'll make a delicious meal again tonight. My father will come back hungry after a hard day at work in the factory. Okay. You can pass through here, yeah. Oops. Another rarer, nice. Engineer Dalton says, steel is not the only product of this factory. Machinery accounts for 30% of all our productions. Machinery? Asks Avon. Miles says, mechanisms that move automatically, right? Yes. Various types of machinery are in use. Representative examples include the control device of the furnace, elevator at the Grand Canyon, they have a Grand Canyon, and prototype engines for ships. Demand for machinery, quote-unquote, should increase further. I'm happy to see that as a design engineer. Why he puts machinery in quotes like that? Hello? Old Man Basso says, the next door neighbor is on their trip to the Holy Capital. She is a meddlesome and nagging old lady, but now that she's gone, I feel unsettled. Really? Oh, is that the locked place we couldn't get into? Yeah. Also, yeah, we don't need that. Get rarer potions. So she's, whoever lived here is on the way to the Holy Capital. Which is good to know. Sabia says, after our neighbor Rael went on a trip, my father lost his spirit. He was fighting with her all the time, but I guess he misses her when she's gone. Great Rael. Alright. Next batch of houses. Interesting, the mine carts and stuff. Hello? The worker says, this factory produces hard. Your grammar doesn't work hard enough, but flexible steel from the iron ore is excavated from the Guia mine. Wait, okay. Let me fix this sentence. This factory produces hard? Even that doesn't sound right. Okay, no wait, hard but flexible steel. Oh, okay. This factory produces hard but flexible steel from the iron ores excavated from the Guia mine. Got it. Our steel is used to make items of daily use as well as weapons you're carrying. Let me show you our weapons. Ours could be made of plastic. Really? Avon says, I didn't know. Miles says, so you're helping us indirectly. The factory has full support of the royal family. If something happens to the factory, the supply of weapons will be cut. Well, we can't have that, can we? I want this scroll. Give me that. Give me the scroll. Okay, never mind. So we were working our way up this way. I talked to him now. She's the one making dinner for her father, I think. Oh, interesting. I wonder if he can get up there. I can go down. Alright, before we go down, let's explore the rest of whatever's up here. Oops. Actually, there's not much else up here. The boy says, "Hey, you!" Quick, little one, aren't you? Haha, I'm over here! "Hey, you're that boy," says Avon. "Yo-ho, it's me again!" "That was rude," says Avon, running away from us like that, and now you just come out of nowhere again? What's with you? "It's a long story." "How about you? Where are you going?" "There's only a factory in that direction." "We're going to the factory," says Avon. "A friend of ours is working there." "Really? I have a friend there that works there too." "Oh, I haven't introduced myself yet, because a friend's the same person. My name is Rael."
"I'm Avon."
"I'm Mile."
"Avon and Mile. By the way, you said you belong to the Adventurer Guild, right? Is your job to fight monsters?"
"It's not the only thing we do," says Avon, "but we do fight monsters frequently." Yeah, see last episode.
"Do you want a black spell expert to help you fight monsters?"
"Well, that would be helpful."
"I can use black spells myself, but the sword is my real strength."
Mile says, "I can only use white spells. It would be helpful if we had another person who was good at black spells traveling with us."
"Okay then, I'll come with you."
"What?" says Avon.
"Can you use black spells?" says Mile.
"I'm a student at the sorcery school. I'm better than anyone else when it comes to black spells."
"A sorcery school?" says Avon.
Mile says, "It's the only institution specialized in teaching sorcery in Elfilden."
"I didn't know they take in such young students like you."
"They decided to enroll me because I am sort of a genius."
"Ahem."
"You don't look like a genius," says Avon.
"Anyway, I guarantee you'll have a better chance at winning fights if I'm with you. You must take me along."
This poor kid who knows nothing about us. It could be a bunch of bandits.
Avon says, "As we said before, we are looking for someone right now. We have no time to play with a kid."
"I'm not a kid, and I am not playing. I have power, I'm..."
Oh, is she coming?
"Just think about it, please."
It's the woman again.
"He's so fast, I can never catch him when he runs away."
"I'm sorry to bother you again. Did you happen to see that boy again?"
"You mean that boy named Rael? He was just here, then he ran away."
"Did he do something?" asked Mile.
"Oh, I'm sorry. My name is Eleanor. I teach at the sorcery school. Rael is my student. He's been skipping classes lately, so I came looking for him in an attempt to bring him back to school."
Avon says, "No wonder he was running away from you.
If you have seen Rael, could you please tell him to go to school? Tell him that if he continues to skip classes, he'll be in great trouble."
"We can tell him, but I doubt he'll listen. He really hates studying, doesn't he?"
"He has a talent for sorcery."
"Actually, he has too much talent. That's the problem."
Miles says, "How can someone have too much talent?"
"Oh, my class is starting. I'm sorry, but I must go now."
Avon says, "Being a teacher is not easy. I couldn't handle those rotten kids."
"I don't think you can criticize the boy, Avon.
Don't you remember? You were one of those rotten kids. You got in trouble so much by Remulus."
"Oh, it's getting late. We should get to the factory."
"Oh, hello."
Gatekeeper says, "I'm sorry, but the general public can't enter."
Miles says, "Is there a boy named Ruka working here? We came to see him."
"Oh, you two are friends of Ruka's. Then you can come in."
Avon says, "Can you let strangers in so easily?"
"We have nothing to hide here."
"I think Ruka is in the plant manager's office. Be careful not to bother other workers."
Alright, we're not going in there just yet. We're not done here.
"I overheard. You are Ruka's friends. Anyone who's a friend of his is welcome. Tell me anything you need."
"I guess we don't need..." I thought that was a way off. Nope.
Miles says, "They say Ruka is working at the factory. Let's go."
West is Baloa.
Oh, okay.
Karuna and Sorcery School. Well, let's go down. Talk to these people. Oh, look at the way we... Look at that. Boop, boop, boop. Seems like... From here. Oh, what'd you find? I don't need that. Boop, boop, boop. Yeah. Oh, Karamus! Mumbling. What shall I do? This is the same as before. Mumbling. Miles says, hey, is it you, Mr. Karamus? Huh? Huh? Oh, good. It's you guys. You showed up at the perfect time. What's wrong? Says Avon. Are you running from GMA again? I will not be forced to write. I write whenever I feel like writing. That's the secret of creating a good work. Anyone can write when they feel like writing, says Avon, but a professional should be able to write any time. Whose side are you on? You're so mean. I guess you are right, though. Anyhow, give me something to write about. Huh. You shouldn't be begging for help. You're too good for that. If you don't have any new stories, that's okay. I can always make up stories about you in a new issue of Quick Raven. Miles says, please don't do that. Write only the facts. I can't believe this guy, says Avon. Avon told him about the adventurers he had encountered. Right, aha. I see. This may be it. I have inspiration. Did you have an idea? Asked Miles. Well, a flame of creativity is burning inside me. The spring of literal arts in my heart is overflowing. Yeah. And now I must write. That's good, says Avon. Thank you. I appreciate your help. Okay, I'm going to write. He goes to this place and encounters that. My pen is flying. Somebody stop me! Can't even see where we're going. Up. Oh, found something down here. No, I don't need that. Oh, we can go in there. Oh, cool. I love these little subterranean dwellings. Oh, hello. Oh, you're the Adventurer Guild. Meister. Says, hi there. Do you need our service? Not really, says Avon. We're actually adventurers ourselves. Are you? You look awfully young to be adventurers. A boy wearing a red bandana, and another with golden hair. Are you Avon and Mile by any chance? How did you know? You chased out the Siam Seal gang from Tibri, right? You're kind of celebrities now. I also know about the water match. It's blown out of proportion, says Avon. I practically won the match because of luck. Ha ha ha. But there are customers who ask for the adventurer who beat Lightning Douglas. I don't know what to say. Miles says, think positive, Avon. If you become famous, Emel may hear about you. Don't worry. You think it so lightly, says Avon. I don't know the details, but you two seem to get along very well. There was a famous duo called Ramona and Blade in Deuces across the sea. I want you to become a great adventurer duo comparable to Ramona and Blade. Well, that's nice, you want that. We have charms lined up for you, so come to me anytime if you feel like working. Like what? I can't ask you, huh? Max says, I hear a serious problem broke out in New Boren. I wonder how Douglas is doing. Do you know Douglas? Well, yeah. You must be adventurers, then. I'm also an adventurer. Douglas and I go back a long way. Many people know me as Max the Babyface in Guia. Miles says, well, if you and Douglas go back a long way, that means you are the same age as him. Oh, I get it. That's why they call you Babyface. Stop right there, says Max. Although I know how I look, hearing it from others makes me sad. Avon says, but you have such a baby face. You don't look any older than we are. Avon, says Miles. All right, Max says, I forgive you. Anyway, what's going on in New Boren? Avon says, things have settled down in New Boris. Mipha's helped us. Mipha? It's the animal that smells good, right? A wondrous thing does happen. We had unconfirmed information about the situation in New Boren, so we were worried. I'm glad the problem was resolved. Any jobs for me? Yes and no. We don't want to do any jobs. We need to find our friend and his sister. Welcome. We can answer all your weapon and protection needs. Or sell you stuff. A great sword for Aven, Estoc battle axe. Ordinary axe modified for combat, characterized by twin blades. Okay, neither of us can use it, so I'm assuming we're going to pick up someone who can. Valditz? Ditto. No one can use it. A large blade is held on a long curved handle. Swing it about just like an axe. This one's 600 roses more. Those are all axes. Fighting axe with a rectangular blade. Looks like a hammer from the front. We've seen those. Megiddo Frail? Oh, this should be flail, not frail. Heavy flail for fighting large monsters. Not only large, but made of 100% iron. Cross blades. Ooh. Large throwing weapon shaped like a cross. Very powerful and accurate. A mile. Gotta do our exchange thing, though. Actually, we have enough, though. Metal jacket. Is it a full metal jacket? Armor worn made by woven steel threads, protects against sharp nails and fangs. Wow. Mile and Aven can both wear that. Let's do the exchange. That's exactly how much money we have. We fought a lot of monsters, so we can afford some of this stuff. I'll take two metal jackets. And a cross blades. See you again. Yes, you will, because we're going to sell some stuff. Long menu. Metal jacket. Defense up by 4. Same here. And then going from Battalia to Crossblades, attack up by 12. Wow. Wow, we have 4 ringmails. I'm thinking about saving one or two for people who join, but let me just sell it. They'll probably come with something good anyway. If not, maybe we'll come back here and get them something. Catalia. Yeah, if he can't have that. Well, his defense isn't too much lower than Even's. Potions and stuff in here? Oh. Hi there. We have a selection of quality tools. Please come to the counter. We have useful tools here. I'm sure you do. Speed Charm. Talisman containing Dash Spell Insider. Increases speed for some time. Protection Spell. Oh, they mean inside, not insider. Magic Shield Inside. Wristband. Cross Helmet. Iron helmet covering the entire head, made by several curved iron plates. Kachucha. Charmed head protection gear for women, also a popular accessory.
yellow crystal containing earth power inside. Increased resistance against earth attack. Anti-chaos is good against confusion. Pet food. Do you have the royal pet food? Oh, red pet food. Red and spicy pet food. Green pet food. Bitter pet food made from vegetables. Alright, let's get two of these. Two of the red ones. Makes the jaws strong. Let's get two of these. Aww. Enjoyed by baby pets. Let's get one of those. Thank you. Please come again. Ina says, hi there. If you need anything, my husband can help you. He already did. You silly, silly woman. Just curious if we can talk to this guy on the other side of the counter. Sometimes they say funny things. I'm sorry, can you come to the counter? Nope. Bye. I can't be on the stairs when we talk to these people. Teo says, hi there, welcome. We have delicious drinks, food, and soft, comfortable beds. The Adventurer Guild is just upstairs, too. Yes, we've been. Professor Maggot? Professor Maggot says, do you know the Sorcery School? It's a research organization for sorcery established by the royal family. I wanted to learn sorcery outside the Bardas Church. Enrolling in the school was the fastest way to achieve my aim. Oops. Nope. Hi there. The cafeteria is in the back and rooms are downstairs. Okay. Beck says, is this your first time in Guia? I come here to play steel orders. I'm always overwhelmed by the omnipresence of machinery here. We can't go behind the counter. Oh my, we have handsome guests. If you order a main dish, the soup is free. Why don't you sit down and have a meal? We cannot. We are forbidden. Do you need a room? Please come to the counter. Any roses. Okay. Oh wow, it's a long way down. Plant manager's wife says, hi there, I don't remember seeing you. Are you visiting Guia for the first time? Avon says, yeah, we came to find someone. Have you seen a girl with red hair? Well, well. Are you looking for your future wife by any chance? I have many portraits of young girls. I remember some of them had red hair. Could you wait for a while, please? You're mistaken. I'm just looking for my sister. Don't worry and leave it to me. I will find perfect girls for both of you. Let's get out of here, shall we, Mile? Mile says, one who is distant avoids danger. Handsome boys like you should have a lot of demands anywhere. Come, let me draw your portrait so I can show them around. This was how it was done before social media, guys. They painted portraits and just handed them around. What we got here? Books! I like books. Yes, I do. There's a book entitled Easy Recipe with Eggs 2. Would you like to read it? No, because I'm assuming here is 1, so let's read 1 first. Very important. Fluffy Soufflé. 1. Whip egg white until fluffy. 2. Melt a heap of butter in a pan. 3. When the butter is sufficiently hot, transfer the whipped egg white. 4. When the egg white has risen, transfer it onto a warm plate. If the plate is cold, the soufflé will shrink. 5. Sprinkle your favorite sauce on top. The soufflé is tasty, just with butter or salt.
Riveting, huh, guys?
Easy recipe with eggs, too. Cheese omelet. 1. Beat eggs.
What a meanie.
2. Put a little sugar, milk, salt, and pepper. 3. Melt butter in a hot pan and pour the seasoned egg. Control the fire, as the egg will get burned easily if the fire is too strong. 4. Place small cheese cubes uniformly on the egg. 5. Before the egg hardens, roll it and transfer onto a plate. 6. Pour your favorite sauce on top. Eat the omelet while hot.
Your favorite sauce. Forget about the portraits. You have errors in your books.
Is that it for the downstairs areas? It looked bigger from downstairs. That's it. By the way, we have many guests today. We just had strange visitors looking for the plant manager. I think that was us. I overheard. You are Ruka's friends? Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay, next time, guys. Next episode, The Factory. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.